Coming out of Afghanistan, keeping our eye on some other major developments in Iran. The foreign minister there dismissing tough new U.S. sanctions. He calls them, quote, part of a psychological war meant to sow discontent among Iranians. He says they will do nothing to stop Iran's nuclear program. Meanwhile, Iran's parliament summons President Ahmadinejad for questioning today and issue a long list of accusations, including mismanagement of the nation's economy. With us now, former defense and national security reporter for the Washington Times, now setting out on a brand new venture as senior editor of the just-launched The Washington Free Beacon, Bill Gertz. Bill, congratulations on this launch. We'll talk about it at the end of the segment. But first of all, Ahmadinejad gets called on the carpet. Is he in political trouble?
Well, John, any discussion of internal Iranian politics requires some carefulness because we're dealing with shadows. That said, it does appear that the Islamist hardline factions in Tehran are going after Ahmadinejad, basically viewing him as less Islamic and more of a nationalist. So that's something to watch. Whether he will actually be ousted or not is not clear, but clearly I don't think they disagree on a lot of the big issues. There's no movement on giving up their nuclear program, or at least complying with international regulations.
He's the public face of Iran that we know, but he's not the power. I mean, the power lies with the mullahs, and particularly Khamenei.
Yes, Khamenei is the power, and also you have to understand the power structure there. It's all behind the Islamic Revolutionary Guards Corps. They're really running the show in Tehran. If Ahmadinejad runs afoul of the IRGC, then you could see some big problems. He is term limited. There are also allegations of corruption and favoritism. I think there's a lot of focus on that, but whether or not he'll be ousted or not still remains to be seen.
So much arguing about whether or not Iran is close to a nuclear weapon. Some say it could happen this year. Some say the window is much longer than that, perhaps 3 or 4 years. Where do you fall on that timeline?
Yeah, well, we just had testimony last week from the top intelligence officials, and they gave a very troubling picture. They don't have good visibility. One of the questions that came up in the Senate hearing was, how will we know when Iran has made a decision to build a nuclear device? I think that the IAEA's latest report really shows that they already are on a track to develop nuclear weapons. It shows that they're building triggers for nuclear weapons devices. They're designing warheads for missiles, and they're also planning preparations for a test. You have to conduct a test, or at least share data from a test, in order to be declared nuclear power. But the estimates are it could be 1 year, but I think that we really don't know, and we don't have good intelligence. They could be much further along. And of course, this brings in the Israeli response calculation.
Bill Gertz knows defense and those kinds of issues better than just about anybody. You're 12 hours into the Washington Free Beacon, right? Tell us about it real quickly.
Yeah, this is a great new startup newspaper. We're going to do a lot of in-depth investigative reporting. We're really going after a lot of stories that aren't being covered sufficiently. And I think that we're really going to make our mark on Washington journalism. I kind of call us the SEAL Team 6 of Washington journalism.
Wow. It's going to be interesting to see how it goes. Bill Gertz, thanks for joining us. We'll keep an eye on the Free Beacon.
Thank you.
You bet.